We're going to talk about artificial intelligence in geosciences, and specifically in relation to landslides.
Okay, so artificial intelligence is sometimes sounds like a buzzword for now. Why is it so important for geosciences?
There are several reasons why it's important. Let's do a step back and let's look at the problem that we are facing. So what we are trying to do as a scientific community is try to inform prior to a disaster, for instance, say mayors of a town or institution that govern, like that manages the territory where we're working on, locations that may be more prone to exhibit or to experience landsliding. So this is one thing that is a fundamental, topic where artificial intelligence is extremely relevant. And another element is to predict things in near real time. So as a disaster occurs, we would like to provide, for example, Red Cross. We would like to inform any other civil protection where to help, where not to help, or which path to take or not. So why artificial intelligence is particularly important in these two elements is that, for example, compared to statistics, what statistics typically has been extremely diffused for or spread for in the scientific community that works on landslide, is that we can look at past events and find relationships between landscape characteristics and past landslide scenarios where hundreds or thousands of landslides occurred within the same triggering event, an earthquake or a storm, and then learn from those, let's say, relations that exist, for example, between slope, geology, and other characteristics, in order to make a prediction. Now, statistics is an extremely useful tool because it's extremely interpretable. So it's a super good tool to be used. But at the moment, people are trying to push more onto performances. And when it comes to performance, artificial intelligence tools, for example, deep learning, are typically ensuring a higher predictive power, though at the expense of interpretability. So that's a little bit about why AI is good.
Do we gain performance because part of the statistical process is done by hand? Or
No. The data sets that you can feed to a statistical model and to a deep learning one, they are essentially identical. It's just that the statistics needs to obey some rules, okay? So you need to sort of reflect the distribution of data that it's priorly defined, where artificial intelligence, for example, does not have that constraint. And also, depending on the model you use, you can have a linear combination of linear characteristics in statistics or linear combination of nonlinear characteristics, which makes it still in a way that you can open the box and still understand each of these elements one by one. While if you let your deep learning architecture run, then it can become so complex that you cannot open that box and understand what happened in there. You can only rely on the prediction it provided. That's the clear difference. And at this moment, a large portion of the community is trying to push to deep learning for obvious reason, because it's performing better, though we need to ask ourselves, what are we losing and we're gaining from that?
Okay. And what type of application can be built? Can you give an example of something that...
For example, I mean, you can... In terms of landslide, you mean? So in terms of landslide, what can you build is... For example, you can train a model to predict where landslides may occur tomorrow. So it will look at a past, and then it will say, okay, along the landscape, please assign a label, stable or unstable, to each slope, so that I know, for example, in master planning, that I shouldn't build on a slope that is likely to experience a landslide, or, for instance, whether I have, I don't know, €1 to invest, I can invest it to stabilize a given slope that requires attention, rather than investing on a slope that is probabilistically stable and therefore wouldn't require an investment. So it's a way to prioritize also what action is more appropriate to take.
Okay. One thing that comes to mind is that all this AI processing comes to a cost in terms of, let's say, heat generated and energy used for the processing. And how does that levels out with the benefits?
I mean, we have a room that we leave open because we have a GPU computer going like crazy all the time, so it's super warm, so I fully agree with you. But typically, you can also speed up the process. Now there are parallelized tools where you can essentially reduce the heat generation and being eco-friendly, though keeping generating information that it's good for disaster risk reduction. So, yeah.
Okay, thank you very much.
No worries. Thank you.
Do you want to be a geo hero as well? Then take the first step and click the subscribe button and then the bell button to always be the first to know when one of our geo heroes posts a new video.